Yes, I finally got to see a completely wireless 55-inch TV called Displaced TV that doesn't have any power cable and doesn't have any wires to connect to. It's a thing you can just hang up on a window. Displaced TV is a 55-inch 4K TV that weighs under 20 pounds and has its own hot swappable batteries. There are four inside that should give it about a day of use. You can swap them out while the TV is still running. The TV has its own suction cup system that can attach to apparently nearly the surface. We saw it attached to a glass window, which is cool. Apparently it can also attach to other walls as long as they're flat. And it hangs there and plays your stuff. It's got a standard kind of smart TV type interface. And the way it works is by streaming the content from a concealed processing box that's supposed to be about the size of a PC power. I didn't even get to see that part. Apparently it's still kind of in the works. But you can imagine this is something that's gonna wanna be tucked away versus put under your TV. Displaced TV is a platform that can run multiple TVs at the same time off of that same processor box. You could run six TVs or eventually up to maybe eight, all of that same system. And that was the original concept of the design. Then it also became wireless and is also battery powered. It's not that surprising to me for the reason that I feel like we've seen this kind of tech happening elsewhere. VR headsets are increasingly streaming from other devices like PCs. We have tablets that are running on batteries and play your TV shows. You have streaming games. It makes sense that televisions would enter that spectrum. Displaced TV, though, does look like it's its own kind of self-contained ecosystem, and it's not that cheap. It's $3,000 for one screen and the processor box, or $9,000 if you want to get four screens and a processor box. We played a few sample videos from CNET to take a look at how it performed. It looked nice. You know, it's hard to judge a TV in a demo situation in a hotel room, but it was very cool that it hung up on a window. It kind of makes me wonder what other places you'd put a TV that you wouldn't normally put a TV. Displaced TV also supports hand tracking for gestures, but it goes a step further by not even having a remote at all. I'm not sure how I feel about that. In fact, I do know how I feel. I want a remote, but the makers of Displaced TV feel that this is good enough that it can work with just hand gestures. My experience of hand gestures is that your mileage definitely varies. But clearly, Displaced TV is going for an unusual type of customer and a future-forward type of person. Whether this technology expands into other types of televisions, well, you could kind of expect that it would. But this is the type of stuff that you see every year at CES in Las Vegas, where new types of tech are being thrown against the wall, literally, to see if they stick.
Apple's HomePod just got a cool new software feature, and it didn't even require a software update. You can now use sound recognition to be alerted of smoke detector, carbon monoxide detector alarms going off in your house, even when you're not home. I'm Jason Cipriani, and in this ZDNet how-to video, I'm going to show you how to turn the feature on and what it looks like when it's triggered. Alright, so Apple rolled out a new architecture for the Home app. A few months ago, there was a bunch of issues with it. It totally forked some HomeKit installations. I was one of those people that had to go through it with the release of iOS 16.3. The HomeKit architecture was once again re-released in iOS 16.4, and it can be enabled by HomeKit users. The reason I'm telling you this part of the equation for sound recognition is you have to have the new home architecture activated and upgraded on your HomeKit system in order for this feature to work. So what you'll need to do is make sure your HomePods are updated to iOS or HomePod OS 16.4. Then in the Home app itself, you'll need to go into Home Settings, Software Update, and upgrade to the Home architecture. I haven't read about widespread issues in upgrading to the architecture since the re-release. But if you want sound recognition, you need to use the new architecture and have it upgraded in order to enable sound recognition. If you want to hold off, that's fine. You just can't use sound recognition. It's up to you. So once you have all of that taken care of, the easiest way to go about doing this, and the easiest way I was able to do it was Apple rolled this out this week. I waited 24 hours and then woke up to a message on my screen letting me know in the Home app, that is, that there's new safety and security features available. Sound recognition detects smoke or carbon monoxide alarm sounds and allows you or allows home members to check in during critical events. I tapped on continue and turn on, and it automatically enabled it for all HomePods in my home kit or assigned to this home. There's another way of doing that. You can go into, if you don't see that prompt, you can go into the Home app, select any HomePod that's currently added to your home, and then you'll go to the settings portion of it. You can either tap on the settings gear icon or scroll down until you find sound recognition. Tap the switch to turn it on. Then you'll see a list of devices or HomePods you can turn it on in your home. Select the ones you want to have on. Turn the ones off you want to have off. I mean, why not leave it on? You already have HomePods in your house with the mic always listening for the trigger phrase. I'm going to say it right now so I don't trigger my HomePod. But why not let them listen to alarms? Pretty simple, dead easy to activate. What does it look like when an alarm goes off? Well, I have a HomePod right here. I'm going to put it in test mode. I have a HomePod Mini across the room. We'll see what happens. I just tested this inside and freaked out my entire family because it sent alerts to everyone that's added to the home. So I have given them proper warning that there will be more alerts coming. I'm giving you a proper warning that this might be loud. I don't know. Turn down your volume. If you have headphones in, definitely turn down your volume. I'm going to set this off on test mode, and then we'll see what happens as far as push alerts go on my phone. Last time it took about 30 seconds. Breaks through, do not disturb, breaks through everything. You heard the noise, it's a special noise for critical alerts in the Home app. The alert says, an alarm sound was detected by Office HomePod Mini, which is the HomePod I have sitting over there, check in now. So if I open it, so checking in means I can listen in to the audio. Checking in means I can listen to the audio on my iPhone that is being captured by the HomePod Mini. So if I was away from home and I needed to check in to make sure everything was okay and see if an alarm was really going off, I can do that just by tapping on the alert on my phone. I don't know if you can hear it, but the HomePod said, hey, a family member is checking in on this HomePod. If you don't want them to be able to listen, double tap on the top of the HomePod. It's a privacy feature, pretty handy. But I can then listen, no one was home, I can listen, see if the alarm was really going off, if